Welcome back, crafters. This week I'm going to show you how to make the gumball machines that everyone seems to enjoy trying to make, but sometimes it's difficult to find the supplies that everyone else is using. So I'm going to show you a few different things that you could use. Typically, you start with a terracotta pot. Mine have holes, but they don't need to have the hole. And there's some different sizes depending on what you're using for the globe at the top. These two are already painted white because I had used them in a previous project to make mushrooms out of them. These are also terracotta pots. If you'd like to know how I made those, I'll leave the link in the description below. This one was one I did when I was little. There's actually a little ladybug. I think it was a button, and I had painted it. So I'm going to be using that. And I think the ladybug kind of looks like the coin piece to the gumball machine. So I had also made this little honey jar. It was all glass, and I made it into this. See, it's glass. This texture on it. I will also link that below, but I was planning on using it as my honey jar. I bought it from Dollar Tree during the summer, but I haven't been able to find more, so maybe in the summer you can keep an eye out for it because it makes a really nice topper, depending how you like it. So that glass container makes a great option if you can find it. Another option I thought about using is this glass ball that comes apart and then it clips. There is this little tiny tip on it. Since my terracotta pots have a hole, it'll feed in there nicely and just sit in there and you can glue it. Or it doesn't fit in the small one though. You can always just cut it off and make a nice globe that way. Then if you wanted, this one's a little big for it, but you could use the terracotta plate and put it on top along with a pom-pom, or this is called a felt ball. That could be a nice way to do another gumball machine. Then I also thought of big Christmas ornament. This was also from Dollar Tree. This could be that little topper piece, or if you want to make your own, that kind of shows it better doing it that way. So you could do it that way or that way. And then lastly, I just found this at my Dollar Tree. It's a plastic container. There's a little bottom on it. But I think that also looks like a nice container to use for the gumball machine. And depending on what you like, you can do different size of terracotta pots. I'm still deciding if I want to paint this top part or not. And the nice thing with this is that you can open it up and fill it with the candies inside. So I decided to go with this container and the bigger terracotta pot. I'm going to actually paint it red though. And I'm going to do just the top as well red, leaving the bottom half clear. Going to be using a softer bristle to help with the paint go on smooth. And I'm painting the inside of the container so you still have that glossy look to it. If you don't like that, you can paint the other side. For a gumball machine, I'm going to make this little design and I'll show you how I did that. I actually tried two different fonts. This one here is the Smith one.
but when I try to cut it out, it just is a little thin, especially for how small my gumball machine is. So I don't think I'm going to be using that one. The fonts I used this one for the 25 cents and this for the kisses. So to make that, you go over here to text and you type in your text. And then you go over here to the fonts and you pick what font you like. If there is a font that either has a price here or it says download, if you don't have Cricut access, you will have to be paid to use those fonts. So I like going to these free ones, and you can click and see what it'll look like. So we did that. So I'm using the search bar to find it faster. So that's our first font. Now if you notice, I have a curvature to mine as well. So you can click this curve button here and make it as much curved or less as you want. You can also see how much I did on this one. I did about 7. So you could even type in that number here. So we'll do our 25 cents. It's this font. So we'll do a text. And I want the 25 cents to be a little bit smaller. I'm also going to angle this. We'll fit the 25 cents right in there. And then I decided to add a few hearts. You can also duplicate if you don't want to make another one or you want one the exact same size. And just rotate them. One more. You can play around and do them how you would like. Once you have everything to the size you like, select everything. And then you can change your size here. I think I'm going to go with 4 inches wide for my specific medium-sized terracotta pot. But please use a measuring ruler or something to measure yours to make sure it'll fit correctly on your pot. If you want, you can change the color. I'm going to be doing mine on white vinyl so you can see what it looks like. If you want maybe the hearts to be red, you can do that. Maybe just a couple of them so you can see what it'll look like. If you want everything to be the same color, then you will also want to come over here to select everything and hit attach, and that way it'll move as one unit, it'll be resized as one unit, and then when you go to make it, it'll be all one. So see, this one here was not attached, so everything's separate and cut separate. This one I attached, so it all moves together as one unit, and you don't have to worry about the placement when you go to transfer it. I'm putting this on permanent vinyl, and so we will select that when we cut. So I'm going to be using smoked vinyl permanent. And then I always like to put more pressure, and then we will make it.
Okay, we did a nice coat of red on a terracotta pot here. And it's hard to see, but here is a white vinyl that I'm going to place on top. I did change up the design just a little. I decided to do a hood for the eye instead of the squiggly, so I moved that one over to the side. And then I just have some transfer tape I'm going to do. This is called varnishing, and it just helps the vinyl to stick to the transfer tape. Sometimes pieces are a little stubborn, so they just need a little help. If you go slow, and I'm going a little fast. Here's a vinyl on the painted terracotta pot. I use permanent vinyl. Next time, just go a little bit slower and you shouldn't have issues. I was trying to go fast. For some reason I always try to when I do videos, so just needed to take a little more time and not rush it. And then I love how the lid turned out. We painted the inside, which also helps so it won't scratch off, but I like this, how you see the design and the glitter, the shine. I decided to leave the very tip unpainted. So here is the finished piece. If you want, you can apply a little bit of hot glue or super glue to the base and glue that on, but it sits pretty well without. If you use something that's more circular, then I would recommend gluing it on so it stays. So if you used the ornament, plastic ornament or something like that, that doesn't have the flat ball at the end, flat edge at the end. And then we have to fill. Fill it with some kisses. If you want more in-depth instructions and a list of supplies, please visit my website, knfdesign.com. The link will be in the description below. Please subscribe and like my channel. It really does help. And until next time, happy crafting!